That we see features that now that the leaves have fallen. This confirmed that none of the trees have been identified as bat roost or hibernation sites, and the proposed removal can take place without recourse to further surveys or licensing by Natural England. And I know that in the case officer's report that wasn't mentioned. The existing building is plain and purpose built and has limited architectural merit. The proposed building will be located within close proximity to the existing building to form an L shape, creating a central courtyard and parking area. The layout of the building has been influenced by the need to retain a tree line to the west of the site in order to maintain the wooded character of the area. The building will also be located 23 metres away from the southern boundary with Pensby Hall. In addition, the elevation facing Pensby Hall will be at least 42 metres away, and it is considered that the combination of the reduced scale of the building and improved design features significantly reduce the impact of the setting and character on the greater listed building. The reduction in the footprint of the building compared to the previous application that was withdrawn is significant. The length of the elevation facing Pensby Hall has been reduced, and the mass scale design of the roofline has been amended to soften the impact. This elevation has been set back to be in line with the existing Barncroft building, and the introduction of gable features to be set back within the elevation helps to reduce the visual impact on Pensby Hall.
You have just under 1 minute.
Okay. The use of dormer windows and materials including buff bricks creates a more domestic appearance that helps to blend with the residential character of the area. Access to existing transport and community facilities exists, and the proposal for 100% affordable housing meets a borough-wide need. The proposed development will not result in any harm to the amenities of the occupiers of adjacent houses and is in keeping with the pattern of development and character of the area. The layout and scale of the proposed building relates well to surrounding residential properties and would not result in a detrimental change in the character of the area and will not have a detrimental impact on the setting of the adjacent greater listed building. Proposal therefore accords with the National Planning Policy Framework and UDP policies and waste local plan policies. And finally, the proposal is an extra care facility which aims to contribute to the current demand and the likely growth in this demand due to the aging population of Wirral with the combination of housing support and care needs. There is a need for this type of specialist accommodation in this area, and as such provision supports both rural strategic housing and social care priorities. Thank you.
Well done, just in time. Thank you. Is there a ward councillor that would like to speak on this? Would you like to come forward?
Thank you, Chair.
Could I ask you to state your name for the record and turn on your microphone, please, ma'am?
Yep. My name's Mike Sullivan and I'm a local councillor for Pensby and Thingwall. Good evening, everyone. And may I say how intuitive and instructive this has been, me sitting at the back and listening to you, learned people. The judgments of Sullivan, Dave. Yes, it isn't quite unusual that I'm speaking for the applicant. Normally, I come here speaking for the objectors. But in this case, none of the objectors and the main objector, Martin Hubbard, hasn't approached myself, or to my knowledge, any of my colleagues, to represent them, which is quite unusual. The first thing I'd like to do is there's a petition, and we are involved with a lot of petitions, I think we all are, to support our cases. I'd just like to bring to the attention of the committee this petition. I've identified 10 people on this petition who signed it twice, and Mr. Hubbard sitting behind me there is one of them, and it is important that we get petition drafts.
It is, Mike, but it's still a qualified petition because it's only 25.
Oh, it is, and yes, I've got no problem. I'd just like to draw your attention to that. Petitions should be right. Magenta Living carried out 3 consultations. I went to the last one, and I was there from 4 o'clock to 6:30. Nobody approached me with objections apart from Mr. Hubbard. And with regard to Pensby Hall, I spoke to the representative. The people who live in Pensby Hall are elderly, and they had a representative there, John Pike. And he said to me, with the new application, they withdrew their objection. Pensby Hall. So this is a 21 apartment. Now I must confess, I've got a vested interest in this, because my mother, this is for dementia, people who are suffering with dementia. I think these type of apartments are sorely needed right throughout the borough. And my mother died of dementia, so I have got a vested interest in this. The client group, yes, are vulnerable and elderly. The scheme is designed, and as I've said, for dementia residents. The scheme will have a secure, dementia-friendly sensory garden designed by a landscape architect that will be open to residents of the existing Barncroft scheme. The new building will be managed in a way that will ensure it becomes an asset to the existing Barncroft building. And if the committee have had a look at the photographs of when it will be finished, I can certainly endorse that. Residents will become one community, sharing the resources and still retaining the independent space. I would certainly urge the committee to support this application. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Mike. I'm assuming when you say you have a vested interest, it's only in relation
it
to
is, yes.
Your mother having had dementia. Okay, you haven't got a vested interest in the development.
No, I haven't.
I just wanted to clarify that.
I must say, I've been previously a tenant of Magenta Living.
As well.
And I am no longer a tenant of Magenta Living.
Okay.
Thanks, Jim.
Okay, thank you. I just thought it was important to clarify that.
So it's important. It has to go together, yes. Thank you. It was important.
Okay, right. I think that there was two things that Martin Hubbard actually mentioned that I'd like some clarification and then I'll open it up to committee. One of the items was that the roadway wasn't sufficient for two-way traffic. If I could get a comment on that. And the second point was the bats roosting, and I know that Nigel Crompton actually mentioned that there had been a second survey in relation to that as well. So if I can just get those two points clarified, then I'll open it up to committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. Just dealing with the bats, first of all. If you'll see on the late list that we had an additional bat survey under the trees, and it was found that there was no potential for roosts when we went to our environmental consultants. And so as such, that's why we're open the application proceed.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. In terms of the existing highway going up to the site, it is an existing two-way road, so it takes two-way traffic. And the nature of this development and the scale, I don't expect any significant increase in the volumes of traffic that can be expected throughout the tail of that road. So I don't see an issue.
Thank you very much. Can I open this up to committee?
Can we see a plan?
Any comments from the committee? Treena?
It's just a quick comment, thanks, Chair, just to say that I would support any application for extra care facility and affordable housing, given the shortage that we have in the moment. Thanks, Chair.
David?
Thank you, Chair. Yes, we've beaten on the sort of request by the
the developments, I did make comments in my room and there myself. Didn't realise it was for people with dementia, but you never know. Here we are. Thank you.
Any other?
Just see elevation, see.
Okay. we have the elevation testing.
Sure, we
subject to the conditions listed and the additional condition on the late list.
Yeah.
All those in favour of approval? That's unanimous. Thank you, that's carried. Can somebody get Steve back in? Okay, we're going to move to agenda item 17, which is pages 111 to 206, and Joe's going to give us a brief summary on that one.
Brief.
Thank you, Chair. Members may recall that this, the September Planning Committee, they have reached a five-week consultation on our local disability consent orders. Historically, we've been all residents living in Porter Sunlight Conservation Area have been consulted, and some reason the feedback is highlighted at the back of this report. So this report is basically seeking to adopt the Port Sunlight Local Listed Building Consent Order. After adoption, the LLBCO will be subject to continuous monitoring to assess the effectiveness and success of the order. Port Sunlight, the order will encourage village residents to rectify long-standing violations at the back of their properties and encourage and promote the best solutions for replacing severely deteriorated features. Over time, the Trust hopes the order will be a powerful tool for reversing the trend of heritage erosion at the back of their houses. This report is therefore seeking members' approval to adopt the Port Sunlight Local Listed Building Consent Order as per the appendix at the back of our committee meetings.
Okay, are there any comments? Dave?
Very briefly, it's a very comprehensive four-week board. I would like my thanks to the officers who've done an excellent piece of work on behalf of the authority. This has laid down the standards for what we want and what we need to do moving forward. It's going to make it a lot easier, not only for ourselves on this committee, but the officers themselves. I'd like to report it. My thanks, anybody else can join in. My thanks for an excellent report.
Thank you. I think your comments are from the whole committee. My understanding is that this will actually be the first of this type to be approved. So we as a council will be a leader in this. So congratulations. And the report is very, very in-depth, going down to house level. And we're being asked to approve this, so can I ask if we could approve this? Yeah. All those in favour? Okay, that's unanimous. Thank you very much. So we go to agenda item 18, pages 207 to 232. This item seeks again members' approval before planning applications decided under delegated powers between the 12th of October and the 12th of November. Are there any comments from the committee? Are we happy to note that?
Yes.
Thank you very much. There being no other business, I'll declare the meeting closed. Thank you very much for being here.